Next, we will add our dedicated outdoor air system. But first, let's do some cleanup on the Thermal Zones tab. We have some zones that have cooling and heating schedules assigned to them, but they do not have cooling equipment or heating equipment. 102, we don't have cooling equipment there, so we can delete this schedule from that zone. 103, we don't have cooling. 104, we don't have cooling or heating. 105, we don't have cooling. And it appears that we have an extra wall heater. We can delete this too. 106, no cooling. 107, no cooling. 108, we do have cooling on 107. Let's add that back in. No cooling. Next, let's add in the dedicated outdoor air system. Go to the HVAC Systems tab. Click the plus button and scroll down to empty air loop. Add to model. Click in the middle and we will rename this and we will assign some properties to it. We will allow it to auto size for now. Type of load to size on. This is a dedicated outdoor air system, so we will size the system based on ventilation requirement. We will auto-size design outdoor airflow rate. Because it's a dedicated outdoor air system, it will be 100% outdoor air. So we will have to change this heating maximum system airflow ratio to 1. Next, we don't have any cooling tempering for this system. We only have heating. So we will change the supply air temperature design to 67. We need to make sure that it's selected yes for 100% outdoor air and cooling and heating. And then system outdoor air method. We only have constant volume diffusers in the system. So there will be no modulation of the airflow in the system, so we will just go with zone sum. If you do have modulation in the system with VAV boxes, you might go with the ventilation rate procedure. Next, we will go to the library tab and search for air loop HVAC outdoor air system. Drag and drop it to one of the supply side nodes. Select it to edit the properties. We will leave it auto-sized. There is no economizer, so we will leave this checked to no economizer. There is also no lockout, so we will leave this locked checked for no lockout. Next, go to the library tab and browse for fan constant volume. This will be our exhaust fan. Drag and drop it into place. We can rename this. Next, go to the library tab again and drag and drop our supply fan onto the supply equipment node. We will rename this. We will leave all of these fans auto-sized for now. Next, go to the library tab and browse for coil, heating, electric. We have an electric duct heating coil in the system. Drag and drop it to the supply side node. We will just leave it auto-sized for now. Next, we need some way to control the electric heater. To do that, OpenStudio uses setpoint managers. Browse for setpoint manager. There are various different control strategies that you can use. We will select node temperature. Drag and drop to the node. Select it to edit its properties. We'll be controlling temperature at this point in the ductwork. We need a reference node to see how much heat to input in order to maintain the set point. Our reference node will be right before the electric heater. This node right here, node 60. Drop down and select node 60 for the reference node name. We will leave this at dry bulb. And we will set the supply air temperature to 67. And there will be no minimum. We will just set both of these to 67. We don't have any cooling control, so this set point really won't do anything. Next, we need to add in our zones and some diffusers. Go to the library tab and browse for air terminal, constant volume, no heat. This is just a simple diffuser. Drag and drop it into place. Next, select the branch splitter. You can see on the right, a list of thermal zones pops up from our project. Add in the thermal zones that are applicable to this dedicated outdoor air system. Next, let's select the zones, starting with this zone at the top. Most of this information is populated from the main supply air system, so we don't have to worry about zone sizing, you would only use this if you had VAV boxes. But we do want to scroll down and click the drop down for account for dedicated outdoor air system. We will select yes for this. This tells the program to add in the dedicated outdoor air system load effects on that zone before calculating equipment sizes at the zone level. For control strategy, we will just leave it at neutral supply air. And if we leave these two at auto sized, those would default to the default values for neutral supply air, or whichever one you selected up here. You will have to go into the Energy Plus documentation to find out what those values are. For our purposes, we will hard size these. For low, we will say 66. For high, we will say 67. Again, this will not matter because we don't have cooling control on the system. Do this for the rest of the zones. In retrospect, it looks like the low set point would actually be 67, which is our supply air temperature from that dedicated outdoor air system. But we'll just leave it at 66 for now. That's close enough. And finally, because we've got a dedicated outdoor air system that runs 24/7 based on our operation schedule, you can go to the Control tab for the dedicated outdoor air system up at the top. Hit the control button. This is where you will see additional controls for your HVAC systems. Our operation schedule is set to always on discrete. That means that the dedicated outdoor air system operates all the time. We will want to go back to the thermal zones tab and check that the outdoor air system is first on the equipment for each thermal zone. That ensures that the dedicated outdoor air system loads are applied to all of the subsequent zone level equipment. You can see for thermal zone 103, the diffuser comes after the electric wall heater. But really, we want the heat from the dedicated outdoor air system to heat the zone first, and then the electric heater will take up any of the extra load. So what we want to do is switch the place of these two. In order to do that, we can just copy and paste. Click the checkbox, select the wall heater, and hit apply to selected. This created a new wall heater, and then we can go back to the old wall heater and delete it. Now it will apply the dedicated outdoor air system heating to the space first, and then the electric heater will take up the additional load. We need to do this for all of the other systems as well. For thermal zone 110, it's a little bit trickier. We have several pieces of equipment here, and because we have so much equipment, we need to hard size one of these pieces of equipment. For example, we want the dedicated outdoor air system to supply heating primarily, and then next, the electric wall heater will come on to supply additional heat. And then finally, the split system package terminal unit will supply the rest of the additional heat needed. So we need to do the wall heater first. And we will hard size the wall heater to the design. Seven kilowatts. There. That concludes this lesson for adding dedicated outdoor air systems. Thank you. Please like and subscribe.